Hi there, welcome back to part three of the learning Scriptcase from scratch video. This is the second video. We're going to look at Scriptcase system settings. So my name is Nate Carpenter. I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So as you can see, we're in the third part of this course, the development environment. So this is the second video in that course, is in that section. There's about four videos in that. So let's go ahead and get started. So as you know, we're using Global Music Supply, a fictional company, as a case study to guide us in our development. You've set up the database and you're pretty at home in the development environment now. Now you need to be able to configure the environment. So maybe you want multiple users, you want backups, you want some default application configurations and more. So let's go ahead and look at how to customize our Scriptcase development environment. Okay, so here we are in our Scriptcase development environment. And if we go to options and settings, we can access our Scriptcase settings. So wait for that to load here, our settings tab. And as you can see, we have a menu on the left with all of those options. So right now we're in system settings under the system tab. And then we have security, services, update, and licenses. So those are the main areas of our system settings. Let's go to system settings. So this is our main one here. We can set language. There's a lot of different options here, but language is a big one. We can show backup alerts, etc. We can control some session information as well. And we have some different options for sending alerts, etc. We can set up email options if we're sending emails from our development environment. Those are our SMTP settings. And then we can set our time zone, which can be important for different features in our development environment. Next, we have default values. So this is going to be the default configuration of different applications in our development environment. So we have some common settings, such as HTML templates here, initial sorting, and then some options here for grids. So the default width of grids, default width of forms, some different options for tab and menu applications. We'll look at what all of those mean in future videos. So then we have some different header and footer templates, and then different toolbar options, which can be very useful for all of our different applications here, chart, grid, etc. So that's going to configure what options are on the toolbar by default and then what order they're in. Then we can click update and update our options. So those are our default values in our system settings. Next, we have system folders. So these you can set up when you install your development environment, but then you can change them here. So the root path of our development environment, the absolute path, where the libraries are, where documents are saved, where images are saved, where the temporary folder is for things that are going to be thrown out after a period of time. And then under projects here, we have some more settings for projects. So we can see all of our projects. I have a lot of projects here and we can edit them and see what they are. Then under security, we can set our security type. So right now we have users. So we can set our permissions by users and we also can connect it to an LDAP server. We can do groups, so we can put users in groups and set those permissions by our bigger option there with groups, or we have groups and users, which kind of combines them both. We can set permissions by groups and then override it by users too. And we can switch it to LDAP as well if we're connected to an LDAP server. And then we can set up our users. So right now we have a few different users here. I have an admin user and then some different users that I've set up for some different purposes here. But as you can see, we are under the SC basics. We can change the password for that user. We can edit some information. We can see some different information, or you can create a new user. So here's the options for creating a new user. So we put in the username, the email, the password, etc., the confirmed password, and then what privileges they have. So they can be an administrator and be able to do anything. Or we can do some different levels of gradation here. We can check all of the options here if we want them to do everything. And then we can allow which projects they have access to. Then under services, we have online here. So this is, well, what is online, what users are online. So we see our users logged in right there. We can see when they logged in, when they accessed it, etc., and how long they've been online. Then we can back up our entire Scriptcase system right here. So we set up a backup name, click process, and it would download a backup of our Scriptcase system. Then we can restore our backup right here. So here's all the backups that we've done, and we can restore those as we want, or we can upload something to do that as well. Then we have some logging set up in our Scriptcase system here. We can configure what is logged, application creation, editing, etc., services such as backup and restore. All of that can be logged here depending on what we want, and then we can view our log right here. So right now we just have some access entries, as you can see, for admin and SE basics as they've accessed those different things. But we would see more depending on what actions have been completed there. Then under update, you can update your Scriptcase development environment. So Scriptcase pushes updates quite often, bug fixes and new features, etc. So you want to check in there to see if there's new updates and then install it. Then we have our online registration, which we've seen. You can register your system. You can do it offline as well. And then you can request it offline and then register it offline as well to select a file there as well. So then that brings us back to system settings. So that's everything for your general settings in Scriptcase. So you can completely configure it how you want it to be.